The hip is made up of a ball, your femur, the socket, your pelvis, and soft tissues called the joint capsule and the labrum. In a normal hip, the forces of the femur are evenly distributed along the socket. But with hip dysplasia, the socket is too shallow to properly cover the head of the femur. This means that the same amount of force is being concentrated into a smaller and smaller area. This is called static overload. It can cause pain and damage to the hip. We don't know what causes hip dysplasia, but it seems to develop around birth, not from a sudden injury. Over time, these abnormal forces can wear down the cartilage of the hip and damage the labrum. To confirm if you have hip dysplasia, your doctor will perform a physical exam and use advanced imaging like X-ray, MRI, or CT scan. In very mild cases, the symptoms of hip dysplasia can be treated with physical therapy. In most cases, however, you'll need surgery. One surgical option is PAO, or periacetabular osteotomy. Instead of replacing your hip, the surgeon repositions the socket of your pelvis back on top of the femur. This restores contact between the ball and socket and decreases pain in the hip. After PAO, most patients return to their previous physical activities. To learn more, contact the Orthopedics Institute at Children's Hospital, Colorado.